C'est mon père, ça me fait bien tiens. Si me fille dit non kotu, elle a wangle dio. C'est mon père, tu me fais bien tiens. Si me fille dit non kotu, elle a wangle dio.
Good evening, Erawan Radio listeners and viewers all over the world. It's another edition of Health is Worth and So Protect It. Your health is indeed your worth. If you have good health, you don't have to worry about visiting the clinic or the doctor every now and then. And that money goes to your pocket or your savings, and that is how you become rich. Because sometimes medical, cost can take a chunk of your money out. Well, you're welcome to Health is Worth Protected Show on Erawan Radio on behalf of my studio manager, Dr. Setitu, and the health team, Dr. Nestopukwa Juman, and the rest. I want to bring you greetings from the studio and from everyone. It's a very good evening here in the studio, and I want to welcome you all. In case you don't know where you are on Erawan Radio. We are broadcasting live on Facebook and YouTube, also on Modern Ghana Radio. The number to call in case you want to contribute or ask a question or, make a suggestion, the number is 240-280-2633. And in case you want to text, it's 510-931-0946. Well, I was supposed to have Dr. Bidiako on the show tonight, but unfortunately, just the last minute, he was called for an emergency. That is what happened when you're a medical doctor. So unfortunately, he couldn't join us. And Dr. Ennis is also on call. So I am filling in tonight. Tonight, I want to just bring in a quick topic on the principles of staying healthy. How do you maintain your health, or how do you stay healthy? We are going to look at the issues that will help us. I mean, the issues that give us bad health, and what can we do to circumvent, go around them and stay in good health. So please share this link with your friend and your friend's friend. Go to Facebook, type in Erawan Radio, and you will catch us live. Again, we are broadcasting live from Facebook, YouTube, and Modern Ghana Radio. Well, let's begin our show. Said it's going to be a quick evening since my primary presenters are not here tonight, but we have made it our responsibility and commitment to bring you something on health and every Saturday between the hours of 6 and 7. I'm your host, Dr. Charles Boyson. Let's get started. Well, we normally start with a warm-up or trending events. What's going on in the world? I want to start with what is going on social media. You know what? Social media came to make our lives better. I mean, if you weigh the pros and the cons, you can tell that social media has made our life better. But for some reasons that are known and unknown, some people have used this technology to make life for others miserable, therefore imposing psychological effects, all kinds of stress on people. This tool that is supposed to make our lives better, disseminate information and make all of us enjoy information at this age, others are using it wrongly, and they are bashing people. People are bashing themselves. Men are bashing women. Women are bashing women, and vice versa. Somebody goes on Facebook or YouTube or Instagram, Twitter, whatever you call it, and that's a lot of insult, especially people from Africa. Sometimes you wonder, somebody will tell you, I'm hungry, but if I put my phone in front of me and I make some recording and blast somebody, that will make my life better. No, it doesn't. Please, let's use social media wisely. I've made a dedicated program, topic that I've discussed on this program before on my Divine Connection show, and I think one of the Tuesdays, that we have to look at social media very well. whatever information you're spewing out, is it factual? Does it have you know, elements of truth? Is it going to help somebody? Is it going to educate, entertain, or inform? If it's not doing any of these things, then you're harming somebody. Whatever information that comes in, especially when we are spreading information that has not been verified. Our former president, Reagan, says when we say trust, but verify. Of course, don't doubt people when they try to give you some. Trust them, but then do not stay there. Verify the information. Otherwise, you'll be spreading information that is not true. You know, that is on the side. And June is also the month of graduations. Our own little niece, Jordan Jacob Waji, graduated, I think, yesterday. So congratulations, Jordan. She's done with high school. So this month is a month of graduation. Our own daughter, Janelle, also graduated this week. So congratulations to all of them. All right. Last week, we couldn't have a show here because I was in Maryland chilling a little bit. If you look at my outfit today, I'm wearing my alma mater's polo shirt. APSU, St. Augustine's College. If you're in school, you are an Augustinian, August school. But when you finish and you become an alumni, you are an APSUnian, St. Augustine's Power Students Union graduate, or whatever you want to call it. So last week, we were in Maryland, chilling a little bit. We had we had guests from Ghana. We had the president of the NEC, our own Dr. Anthony Osei, who was once the senior prophet. We have Dr. Park Kwesi Ndium, who was also one-time presidential candidate nominee. He was our guest speaker. This guy, man, has done so much for our school, Augustine. So, Dr. Ndium, thank you very much for coming all the way from Ghana, and Dr. Osei for also showing up. We also had the best teacher of the year. I mean, he also showed up at our dinner, so it was awesome. So we had a meet and greet on Friday evening. That was well attended. Saturday, we had a congress where we deliberated on information concerning our school, speed on what executives were doing and what they had to tell us, what is going on, the speech and prize giving day, all the updates that we needed to hear. And then in the evening, we had a gala. I mean, we had the dinner where, like I said, these important, you know, gurus were invited. They were there. Dr. Se was there. Dr. Ndium was there. And the Ghanaian ambassador to the U.S., this lady is a product of Wesley Girls High School. She was there. And incidentally, she had to be present in our dinner and also go to Wesley Girls dinner, which was happening on the same day, because Infant Spring Mobile and Wesley Girls also had their dinner the same day. So she came to our dinner. And she was supposed to stay for about 30 minutes and leave. But then we excited her so much. We made her so much feel at home. She didn't want to leave. But eventually, around 9 or thereabout, she had to leave. And she was even thinking about taking our MC with her. So she had a ball. I don't think she had the same ball at the Wegehe dinner. But anyway, I wasn't there, so I don't know. So that was what happened last week. And then the Sunday, we had a picnic. Prior to the picnic, we had a soccer event with Adisco. So Augustine's and Adisco played the soccer. Yours truly was there. And we bashed them 5-0, 5-0. Actually, it was 6 goals, because we meant to mention Adisco. And as you know, A-D-I-S-C-O. A-D-I-S-C-O. That is 6 letters. So we wanted to beat Adisco 6 goals. We managed to beat them 6, but the referee disallowed one. The ball went into the net, but the opponent said, no, it wasn't a goal. It went out. But, you know, we said, I mean, 5 is enough, so let's just spare them the one. So that's what happened. We almost spelled Adisco. All right. So tonight I'm looking at the principles for maintaining a good health. How do you maintain a good health? And by the way, I had another T-shirt I was supposed to wear for this program, but it didn't work well. That's what Augusto made me nice, you know, T-shirt, but that wasn't well shown on my screen. So I had to make do with this white pool. All right. We're looking at the principles for maintaining a good health. Nothing comes by chance in this world. Even the things that God gives us are done because He orchestrated and brought it our way. So you don't get things by chance. You have to work to be able to maintain something. I believe God doesn't have a problem making all of us millionaires. But the problem is that, are you going to be able to maintain the $1 million? Like somebody who wins a lotto. You know, it just came by numbers and you played and you won millions of dollars. I hear those are the people who go broke very easily. But as for me, if I win lotto $1 million, trust me, I'll use it appropriately. The people I have to give, I'll give. And I'll use it wisely and set up stuff. So, you know, you have to work for things to happen and to maintain them. So we are looking at how to maintain your, in the first place, how to get in good shape and how to be able to maintain it. And I have come with four really major reasons of, you know, maintaining good health. But before I do, let me play Acrobatos clip real quick, and then we'll continue. I love this clip.
Me dindi acrobato. Me ye businessman. At the same time, so me sansu ye actor. Me nyata mpo en makwayare sabia. Eko si se dakro. Me ni me business for. E shi ye meeting. Prekope me call off. Me unu fi biyo. Me nisu te meno. Ne mo banahin specialist hospital. Wow, Enfidieni, machine sa hot duo. Ne mu say yes, hospital. E bidi de biachi.
Mi hu say mayo kakra. Nanka me sa contract bi eneya aji bi bia. Ena problem e bai. Ti kan buti mama akwa kura na masa ba. Ka me ni be jehu pa.
O me worry. E person we o treatment no. Aso your facility wa ha. Be bo na oni business partners na ye meeting. Me da mo se. And hospital kwa na mu. How one I use my minimum cassette? Open to a call to the American for Banahin Special Hospital. Call up, they are ready to help you. Bye bye.
All right, that is the famous Acrobato Health jingle or ad. This guy is in the hospital and still thinking about his business anyway. Well, we are looking at how to maintain a good health, and I want to cite four main ways that we go about receiving good healing, good health, or the four main ways that we can use to stay in good health. And this is what I came with. The four major areas I would say are: one, you can receive a good healing or health through divine touch or miracle. The second point is that you can also have good health through medical intervention. And thirdly, through your body's immune system helping you to stay healthy. And then the fourth one is personal lifestyle. So I'll take this one by one and we'll go through. And like I promised, it's going to be a short presentation tonight. So just to give you something to, you know, keep our lives in good health. All right, so when you talk about the four principles, I'm looking at the first one as being a divine touch. Divine touch or miracle. What I mean is that God still performs miracles. God still performs miracles. And for those of you who are believers and Christians, you will identify what the Bible says. If you are agnostic or you are an atheist and you don't believe in God, you don't believe in miracles, that's fine. I can't really help on that. But I'm speaking to people who are science-based and also believe that there is an aspect of our lives that miracles can work in. So if you look at the story of the man at the pool of Bethesda, that can be found in John's Gospel, chapter 5, verse 13. And this guy had been at the pool of Bethesda for 38 years. Why? Because at every time or every year, an angel was sent from above to go and mix up the water. So whoever falls in, goes to fall into the pool or the water first, receives their healing, irrespective of whatever you're suffering from, whether it's headache, it's any chronic, whatever it is. If you are able to get into the water first, that is when you get your healing. So this guy has been there for 38 good years. No doctor passed by to say, oh, I can treat you, I can do this. And so Jesus approaches this man at the pool and asks him, do you want to be healed? The response this guy comes with, the fact that I don't have any man to help me. Anytime I'm going into the pool, Carl Lewis or, you know, those fast guys go ahead of me. Maybe Jose Bolton was there. They will outrun this guy and they go into the water first. So this guy for 38 years never received his healing. But then divinity met this human person at that pool of Bethesda that day. And Jesus said, I'm not going to push you, help you push you into the water. I'm not going to, but I'm going to heal you. And Bible says, by an act of miracle, Jesus touched this man and said, go and show yourself to the priest. Go and do all that You know, that was how you receive. So sometimes you have divine healing. You might be going through some chronic disease, something that doctors have pronounced, or you have 2 weeks to die, or it could be anything, cancer, anything that the doctors cannot wrap their mind around. You know, medicine came from God. God gives our doctors the wisdom to operate and do whatever they have to do. But sometimes it's beyond them. And that is when God has to supernaturally come in and touch you by a miracle. That is how you receive miracle healing. So one of the ways that you can stay in health, maybe you're going through some, chronic disease that nobody can help you. No herbalist, no doctor can help you. There is a divine healing through miracle that God can touch you. Like it. Jesus touched this man at the pool of Bethesda. He said, rise up and walk. And he did. So we can receive healing through miracle. And I have a few verses. 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 24 says, he himself bore our sins in his body on the cross so that we might die to sins and live for righteousness. By his wounds you have been healed. Psalm 147, verse 3 says, Bible verses, about this, it says, he heals the brokenhearted and binds up their wounds. You might be going through some emotional, psychological, stressful that, it cannot be diagnosed, but then this Bible says that Psalm 147, written by, I believe, David, verse 3 says that he heals the brokenhearted and binds up their wound. Maybe you're listening to me tonight and you have been disappointed by your boyfriend, your girlfriend, your husband of 10, 20 years, and now you are brokenhearted. And some of these diseases, no doctor can even heal you. They might try to prescribe, some anti-whatever to help you, but it is only God who can touch you as a brokenhearted person. So you can receive healing through that. And Philippians verse 4, verse 9, he says, healing comes from God. And he says, and my God, quoting Paul, says, and my God will meet all your needs according to the riches of his glory in Christ Jesus. If God has all these riches in Christ, he can meet you at the point of your need. Whatever problem you are going through, God can supernaturally heal you. And when you look at James chapter 5, verse 16, therefore confess your sins to each other and pray for each other so that you may be healed. The prayer of the righteous person is powerful and it's availed much. So when you read James chapter 5, verse 16, Bible says, when we confess our sins one another to one another and pray for each other, God can work out miracle for us. And Isaiah 41, verse 10 says, so do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will build you up. All right, so Psalm 107, verse 20 says, he sent his word and healed them and delivered them from their destruction. God sent forth his word and healed them. You remember the story where the Israelites were being bitten by a snake all over the place, and Moses, approached God and said, Daddy, what should I do for these guys? And he said, make a brazen stone of an image of a snake and let them look at it. Anybody who looks at it will be healed. Isn't it amazing that the same thing that bit them, God tells them, make an image of that object, that snake, and whoever has been bitten and sees that image will be healed. So that is one area that we can maintain or receive our healing. God touches us supernaturally and miraculously, because there are some instances that people have testified in church that I had this issue, I had this problem, I've gone to the medical doctor for several years, nothing is happening, my whatever is not working, but God, through prayer and fasting, people have received their miracle. So that is one area God heals us. The other aspect is by medical intervention. God created medicine, so it's not wrong. Some of you have been saying, oh, if I'm sick, I am just going to fast and pray and trust God to heal you. I said in the first point, it's good to trust God for it, but sometimes your healing will not necessarily come from spiritual healing. Sometimes it comes from medical intervention. If you have a headache, you can pray, but maybe picking up a Tylenol or as they say it in Ghana, picking up a Tylenol, maybe one tab, 800 milligram, whatever, and taking it with water or something could take away your headache. So sometimes medical intervention is good. You go to see your doctor, they say, okay, based on the lab that we ran, your A1C is high, your sodium is high, your potassium is low, your calcium is so and so, your cholesterol is this, your triglycerides is this, all this. Putting all this lab results together, I, as the doctor, I'm diagnosing, this is what you have. So do this. Okay, go to pharmacy and pick up this medication, which will counteract this disease, and that is the boom, you are well. So the second point is, we have medical intervention that takes care of our diseases or our ailments. So point one, I mentioned a miraculous touch from God. God can touch you supernaturally, where some people receive their healing. Secondly, you can have a medical intervention. Go, you don't feel well. I mean, when COVID came, of course, we are all praying, but we came to understand that maybe if you have the COVID vaccine, that takes care of this bug that was walking around. And so those of us who took the vaccine, we were okay. I mean, we went from dose one, dose two, dose three, and we are okay. Some two are still arguing whether the vaccine was legit or it's, I mean, I'm not going to argue on that. Well, I took it. I'm okay sitting here. So medical intervention is very good. I mean, you go and your doctor will tell you, okay, go and do this routine. Like maybe they take some sample from you. They take it to microbiology. They inoculate, they incubate, and they read it. You know, they tell you, okay, you have staphylococcus or you have salmonella or whatever it is, whatever bacteria, whatever virus. They are able to pinpoint, okay, this is the bacteria that is circulating your body. They give you antibiotics to that, and boom, you are okay. So medical intervention is very good. Those of you condemn medical science, please stop it. God can heal in several ways. There are some that he can just speak the word on you and be healed. Sometimes he will just tell you, go and see your doctor. That is why when Jesus was on this earth, he healed people through several means. He didn't use one size fits all for everybody. He changed his modus operandum. One time he would just hold you and say, oh, daughter, rise up and go. Another time he said, oh, go and wash in the pool of Siloam. Another time he would just touch clay with saliva, wrap it on their eyes and say, go and wash in so-so and so. So there were so many ways that Jesus used to heal people. He didn't use the same approach for everybody. So sometimes God will not just speak a word to heal you. He might just speak to your spirit. Go and see the doctor. Do labs and see what is going on. They are all the way that we can stay healthy and stay clean. All right. The other means, the third point is our body's immune system. This is where our immunity heals and stays healthy. Eating the right stuff. So we understand from science that children, very little children, and those who are above certain age, 65, 70, 80 going, their immune systems are compromised. So when they get any infection, it takes a longer time for them to heal. Those in the middle bracket, your immune system is sharp up there, so you are able to fight it. That is why when COVID came, if it affected kids, that is another thing. If you have, especially the old people, and because it was a respiratory disease, children were kind of, you know, prevented a little bit. But the older people, above 65, 70, 80, 19, they were succumbed because of their immune system being suppressed. If your immune system is suppressed, then that is when you cannot fight diseases. There are white cells in our body that we are all kinds of cells that fight against disease. If you have something in your body, we have the platelets who heal. Let's say you have a cut and you are bleeding. We have the platelets who go to cover the wound, and so you are protected and you stop bleeding. So if your immune system is low, some of all this might not be working very well. You have to check and make sure your immune system is working. That is when COVID came, the shots that we got were able to, you know, mimic or, you know, fool this virus, so that anytime it came over, you say, oh, I already have the shot, I've identified this before, and that also protected most people. So your immune system is very important. You have to watch the things that you eat. Sometimes your doctor will tell you, okay, you are deficient of this vitamin or this nutritious. Please take good. There are most of the nutrient, I mean, vitamins that you don't even have to go buy, them on the shop or store or pharmacy or whatever. Our body, you know, makes the food that we eat. I mean, if your eyes are not good, you have what you can eat. Palm oil and all this, carrots and all this help with your eyes. If you are suffering from vitamin C, they will tell you eat oranges, you know, those. And that could also give you scurvy. So watch if you are lacking vitamin D. For those in Africa, there's abundance of sunlight. Just walking on the sunlight, not too much, can give you a lot of vitamin D. And that same sunlight too can also affect your eyes. So whilst you are enjoying the vitamin D, also make sure you have sunglasses on. So all these things work. There are so many things that God has put in our bodies that fight disease, that our immune system, they fight them, because most of the things that come to us, if we didn't have our immune system being strong, then we'll be suffering. So it's important that you eat right, and these nutrients go to help your body fight diseases and, you know, boost your immune system and help you, you know, stay healthy. And then the fourth point, which is also not the least, is personal lifestyle. Personal lifestyle is very important. If you want to stay healthy, you want to stay away from unwanted activities, it means that you have to adhere to calculated physical, you know, activity. One of them is very important. I mean, walking briskly, you know, maybe 30 minutes a day, running in your neighborhood. If you have the luxury of going to the gym, going to work out, maybe 30 minutes to 1 hour a day. And it's even been said that just, you know, walking 11 minutes a day can do a lot of good to your body. So you have to check it. Personal lifestyle is very important. It's not everything that you want to eat. It is not. We are all trying to stay healthy, and sometimes the food is good. You've been doing a lot of work, going up and down. You come home, it's late, and 11 o'clock, you are still hungry. It is good. But that is not when you want to eat your favorite fufu and, I mean, go to sleep. You've eaten a bowl of fufu, you just want to sleep. The food is just sitting on your stomach. We are all working on our stomach. It's very important. So we have to make conscious, calculated, intentional efforts to modify our lifestyle. That is why it's very important for us to do our annual check. That is when you go, your doctor will tell you, okay, boy or girl, last year you came to see me, this thing was at this result. Maybe your calcium was something, I mean, your sodium was maybe 120, 130, whatever, you're in the range, or this time it's gone to 150. Your doctor will tell you, hey, you were here last year, you have jumped to here, so check it. Your cholesterol has to be less than 200. All of us, we are struggling to keep our cholesterol in check. They will tell you, oh, it's above 200. Work on it. Check the food that you eat. If it's too much radenum and all that stuff, I mean, cut it down. Because when you get a certain age, your metabolism slows down. So the food that goes in doesn't digest and go away easily like when you were a young guy. I mean, these kids are running around chasing balls and doing all that. Their metabolism is high. But then if you are 50 and over, your metabolism just comes to a ground halt. Slow down, me taking me time. So you have to be consciously, make that effort that I'm going to consciously stay healthy. It doesn't come cheap. You have to watch what you eat. Some of the food are so nutritious. I mean, you have this bacon, you have this sausage, you have this, and they are all, you know, calling your attention. You want to eat them. But then you ask yourself, where is this food going to end up? Is it going to clog my arteries? Is it going to help me? You know, you have to, anytime you are putting certain kind of food in your mouth, ask yourself, where is the end point of this food? Of course, it's going to come up finally as feces, but then some will be digested, assimilated into your body. Where is it going to end? Is it going to help your body grow better, or is it going to clog your system and make you stay unhealthy? It's very important that we do that. I think a couple of weeks ago, Dr. Ines and I did something about the importance of our annual checkup. We didn't finish, but maybe before I end, I'll just do a quick summary just to, you know, enlighten those who are not here. So I believe that this advice is helping us in some way. All right, let me take a quick jungle, and then we'll continue. All right, we are back on Erawan Radio. We are broadcasting live on Facebook, on YouTube, and also Modern Ghana Radio. Our ladies, the Real and Common Kitten ladies, have been chilling. We want to see them tomorrow. So for those of you who have not been watching the Real and Common Kitten, let me play a clip of their program, and then you will understand what I'm talking about.
They are four women. They are beautiful with brains. They are eloquent, decent, wise, and experienced. You have heard many. They're funny. Now, it's time to hear the experience and the brainy. Meet Selena, Dorcas, Gifty, and Annette as they present the Real in Common Kitty. In Common BISSE chain, the dead, as in Takrenu assume the dead, the Real in Common Kitty. Showing live this and every Sunday, 7 p.m. on Erawan Radio on Facebook and on YouTube, Erawan Radio and on Taibo channel. Kaise, so we see the Real in Common Kitty. What brabon titty? We yen konkonsa. We ye, the Real in Common Kitty.
Nkomo Nketin ladies every Sunday from 7 to 8, and you will be blessed. Well, let me go back and congratulate our graduates for this year. Anybody who is graduating this year, whether it's kindergarten, whether it's fifth grade, whether it's high school, whether it's college, whatever graduation you are having is a milestone. So pat yourself on the back and enjoy your graduation. Of course, the next level is waiting for you. So just like you are able to go through this phase, you will go through, but it also comes with hard work. So congratulations to everyone that graduated this month or the coming days. Congratulations. And also, if your birthday is today or this month, happy birthday. We pray and wish you all the best. So on the final point before I went for the break, I was talking about the fourth point, which was your personal lifestyle, working on your own personal lifestyle, being able to take your exercises, walking every now and then. It's been actually encouraged that when you sit down for an hour or two, get up and walk a little bit so that, you know, you don't subject your body to the same thing, mess up your waist and all that. So you have to exercise. At the end of the day, you know, if you can do some walking at least 3 times a week, it's been recommended that do some physical activity, even if it's 30 minutes per session. It's very important because you don't want your body, your bones to atrophy or whatever. You want to make sure you are actively working. Your heart is also pumping the way it's supposed to, you know, pump. And then eat right. I mean, I just remembered our friend Absu Aaron, and that we played a soccer with. This guy loves fufu. Oh my God. He is the president of fufu movement. He said he doesn't even have any limitation or any time of eating fufu. Whether it's 2 a.m., call him and he'll be there. So Aaron, well, you might have to adjust some things. Anyway, so I'll end up, I have 20 minutes left. I'll end up with a summary of the importance of having, you know, checkups is very important. Just like you take your vehicle to the shop to get a tune-up, make sure your tires are rotated, your oil is changed and filled with new ones, your transmission fluid is checked, all that stuff. It's also important that you check your body system. Sometimes we don't care. We wait till we have a headache. And trust me, before you have the headache or when you realize you have headache, other systems in your other, you know, tissue sources in your organ body would have suffered to manifest the headache. So make sure you are checking all this, the food that we eat, please. Let's all watch it. Food is good. But then just be careful how much of it you are eating and where it's going to end up. At least do your annual checkup and make sure your body is receiving the right attention. If your numbers, maybe next time I'll be doing some program on knowing your numbers. You have to know your lab numbers, your sodium, what is the range, what is the number for sodium, for chloride, for your potassium. You have to know the range. If you're outside, what is critical results? You have to know all. So that when you go and your doctor tells you, okay, your results for sodium was 121 last year and today is 180 or something, then you know that, Jack, something is going on. We have to watch it. You stay in good health. All right, so the importance of the annual checkups, it's very important. You might be asking, why do I have to do it? I mean, there are five, I did a little bit of reading and research, there are five important reasons why we have to make sure we do an annual checkup, you know. And so the intro was that regular checkups are beneficial for people of all ages. It can help identify potential issues before they start. And early detection of illnesses often leads to more treatment options. So, I mean, many a time people go to their health practitioners and maybe they realize that, okay, there's some growth developing somewhere. If it wasn't there last year, then they know, okay, this developed the after you saw your last, you know, you did your last checkup or something. So they can track, okay, it's been a year or there, but when this thing started growing. So early detection can lead to treatment options. There are some, you know, illnesses that can be treated sooner than later. If they realize early, they can do something. You don't wait for it to outgrow and they tell you, oh, ubantema and kibichmaya ubibi. Please don't let any doctor tell you that as a senka ubantem. That is why these annual checks are very important. I mean, in between, you could have some problems that might take you to the hospital that they will still see. But if you think you are normal the whole year, please, at the end of the year, go see a doctor and see what is going. Check your numbers. And this is a good time to start establishing a baseline with your healthcare provider, especially from 45 going, they encourage colonoscopy. They have to put that thing in your, you know, your behind to, you know, take a picture of your whole intestine and see what is going on. If there are polyps or anything that is growing, they can detect it early. You don't want to wait too long. If you go and it's clean, they'll tell you, okay, come back in 10 years and we'll check it. If they see something that wants to grow, okay, Jack, you have to come back 5 years or maybe sooner, because they don't want to say, oh, you should have come earlier. And that is why it's important that please you take care. Your health is your own life. Nobody will leave it for you, and you have only one life. Trust me, if that body is tired, the spirit and the soul will leave. They will go back to where they came from, but the body will be too bad. So make sure this body is keeping you strong. If it's gone, it's gone. I hear we have only one chance. All right. The more we know about you, the better we are able to tailor treatments best for you. That is one thing that Dr. Carmen Whiting said, who is a family medicine, especially with a UT physician. She shares her expertise on why you should get a medical checkup. It's very important. I did mention about the vehicular tune-ups. Just like you take your even your car that will break down anytime. I mean, cars you can easily replace. If you have an accident, the car is dead, but you can go get another one. But you, the human being, if you die, where are you going to get a spare, spare one? You got only one life. Please tune up your body. Go and let them tell you, even when we're, those days when we're in Ghana, anytime I came back from school, Augustine's, from when I came back, my mommy, you know, they did the enema type, Ghana, yes, sir, seriously. Oh, my mom, Charles, from my mini brother, to be more. My mom will buy Okumadada, that's already prepared, you know, some concoction, whatever. My mom will buy this concoction, and she, there's a syringe, big, we call it bentua. Bentua in those days, big bentua. My mommy put this bentua in the okumadada, and then, you know, by virtue of scientific suction, you know, you squeeze the bentua and then you release it into the concoction. It sucks it and it fills it to a certain level. And then my mommy would make me bend down, you know, and she would slap me. I was very young. She was every time I came from school, because she knew I had gone to eat all this food at school, gari and shito, all those starches and stuff. So your body is, I mean, full of starches and stuff. So she would send me the okumadada to clean my stomach. And then after vacation, we'll go back to school. Either I come back from vacation again, she will do the same process. So when you power bro, you are science. So it's very important that at least you take good care of yourself. You are drinking more water. My wife tells me drink like 5-6 bottles of water every day. Sometimes it's difficult, but you have to. You have to flush your system. I mean, sometimes these kidney problems come because we are not drinking too much water. Water won't kill you. Those of you who prefer pure alcohol to water, please desist from it. Drink more water and leave the pure alone. It disfigures you and it shortens your lifestyle. It makes your liver and your kidneys work overtime. Can you imagine working overtime? I just cut my grass before I came here. I was tired, but I still have to come here. And so you have to keep fit, you know, drink more water. So the reasons why we want to have our annual checkup, get a current assessment on your health. It's very important. Everyone's at a different point in their life. The person who is 70 years today and the person who is 20 years today, they have different lifestyles. Different. 70, there are some things you can't do. I mean, the 20 can bend, twist, flip, do whatever. But you 70, go and try. They will be calling 911 on you because your waist, the bones are atrophied. You can't do something. So everybody has a different life journey. That is why we all have to be careful. But if you are maintaining a good life from your 16s, 20s, 30s, 60s, and 70s, you might not have to worry too much. The body by itself ages. But then, if you have kept a good lifestyle, it will age smoothly with you. All those small things you did 20, you can't do them at 70 at least. I mean, you can adjust. So your family history, your lifestyle, your age, your diet, your activity level, everything affects your health. And so depending on your age, health, and family history, there are a variety of tests that can be performed to help determine if there are any underlying conditions such as heart disease or diabetes, as said by Dr. Whiting. And based on your test results, your doctor may recommend changes to your daily routines or food intake. I mean, if you go see your doctor and they say, okay, you have a high blood pressure, there are two options. Either you take the medication or you change your lifestyle. In some cases, both are recommended. So we have to watch it. And then you have to update your vaccinations. For us in the, you know, active duty, it's recommended that you have to take your flu shot every year, unless there's an exception or you are exempted. But you have to. You have to go and, you know, update your vaccination, especially our kids who are going at certain ages. They have to get some shots. It's very important. You have to get your vaccines. You know, as a female, a teen, there are some shots you have to take, you know, like, you know, pregnant women should get a Tdap against tetanus, diphtheria, and acellular pertussis and all that stuff. And the human papillomavirus, you have to get virus against all those measles. You know, in Africa, you have to get a lot of, you know, shots. And they are, when you go every year, they will tell you, even if you forget, when you go the following year, your doc will look at your file and say, okay, you need this shot. And you have to take it. I mean, if they look at your records and you are missing certain vaccines, they will prompt you. You need them. Here, they don't joke. They don't joke, you know, with these vaccinations. And I understand men and women under the age of 26, you consider getting the HPV, that's a human papillomavirus vaccine. You have to get it. Another issue why you need to get your annual checks done. Review your prescriptions and medications. Maybe you went last year, they gave you some prescription. The doctor can say, okay, based on how you are doing, either he's going to give you a low dose, high dose, or remove any doses. So it's very important that at least 1 year is not that long. 365 days, 52 weeks, you know, you go and they review your medications. Okay, when I saw you last year, I said, doc will say, when I saw you last year, you were doing this year, and this is the medication I prescribed for you. Now, looks as if your lab results are showing great improvement, so I'm going to decrease the, you know, dose, or based on what is going on, let me up your medication dose a little bit. And if you are wearing glasses or something for reading, you know, they will check your eyes, do everything. So, okay, your eyes are maybe decreasing in certain areas here, so, so, and so, so. Let's increase the specs for you so you can see better. That is when you realize. So these are all very important. Why you need to go for a medical, you know, review or checkup every year, every now and then. Some do it 2-3 years, but please don't let it be said that it's too late. You came too late. I mean, a year is good enough for any doctor to be able to review your records and say, okay, you are doing well or doing this. I went to do my annual checkup this year. I realized some things are deteriorating that you have to remedy. So, yes, you have to go on some treatment plan. It's very important. And then another thing, making a lifestyle change. They will tell you, especially if you are smoking, your doctor can tell that, buddy, quit smoking or reduce it. I mean, up to now, I don't know what people get from smoking. Honestly, I don't know. I haven't smoked, so I don't know how it tastes like. Maybe, I mean, I tasted once when I was a kid. You know, I just coughed and coughed or whatever it is. But those who are habitual smokers, smoking like a pack every day, I don't know how they do it. But you are harming yourself. You are making your arteries constrict, and eventually it will catch up. Trust me, there are some things that you do, and you will go scot-free. You enjoy it for now. But in your later years, 70s, when you are struggling or you need your health back, it's going to catch up with you. So this, they bring you temporary pleasure. You know, yeah, the wouldn't smoke now. I remember when we finished Form 5 in Augustine, this guy that was in my class, nice guy. I met him one time puffing this cigarette. I said, buddy, when did you start this? And they thought it was the order of the day. You see them in peer groups and friends and everybody's doing it. So if you don't do it, they call you kolo. So peer pressure, they will force you. Also want to taste them, feel like, yeah, why a guy? Why? I mean, the girls will say, yeah, I love a guy who smokes. Or, I mean, yeah, they say crazy stuff. But, you know, but we have to check it. Some lifestyles have to be, you know, chunked to the backyard or something. Please, they will tell you if the smoking is not helping you, because there are some procedures when you go to do. They'll do a survey or give you a question, ask you, do you smoke and all that stuff. If you smoke, then they will tell you something else to do. If you don't smoke, okay, move on to here. So please, it's very important that we change our lifestyle. If you're exercising maybe once a year, that is not enough. I mean, start slowly once a month, come to once a week or twice a week, and please change your lifestyle. And when you go, your doctor can tell you that if your lifestyle change is helping, they can look at your lab results. Trust me, there is so much in the blood. When you go and the phlebotomist, you know, draws your blood and puts on a machine, and, you know, medical technology put on a machine and they test your blood. There's so much they can see from just by looking at, because, you know, Bible even says that the life of every animal is in the blood. So the blood will tell the doctors a lot of what is going on in your body. Nobody can just look at your face and tell you are suffering from this. Sometimes your physiognomy can tell you what is going on inside, but many a time they won't. It's the blood test that will tell you, okay, your sodium is high, your calcium is this, your potassium is low, and these are all related to, you know, heart issues. So it's very important. And then saving money on long-term costs. I cannot overemphasize the importance of doing annual checks to cut down on long-term costs. For instance, if you haven't checked your system for a long time, you go 3-4 years and they tell you, oh, you have cancer here that is growing profusely. If you had gone yearly, they would have detected it, maybe did some treatment earlier on. But because you waited, now it's become spreading. It's spread all over your body, and that's going to cost a lot. That's why some insurance companies, if you have predetermined illness, they don't want to insure you. But thank God, Obamacare says that even if you have a predetermined condition, they should insure you. So it's very important that we do this to save costs. Something that is detected earlier will save you money than waiting the last minute when you have to spend so much money. You'll be going to the hospital. And now let's, for instance, if you're on dialysis, you have to go maybe twice a week, and it's not cheap. It is not cheap. Apart from the fact that the procedure itself is painful and difficult. I haven't done it before. I don't know. But those who do it, I mean, going to sit there on a machine, sucking your blood and filtering and cleaning it up and putting it back, it is time consuming too. And it's expensive. If you don't have insurance, then poor, you forget you. So it's very important. Some of these things you can detect. And when they run your blood every year, every time you go, it will tell you. Whatever the kidney is suffering from, the blood that they test can tell you. I mean, they have all these kinds of tests they do. If you are suffering from cancer or something, your CA test will tell you, oh, there's these tissues here that is outgrowing in a negative way. So please, 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 I cannot overemphasize it. It's very important. All right, so somebody said this. Regular checkups can help find potential health issues before they become a problem. When you see your doctor regularly, they are able to detect health conditions or diseases early. Early detection gives you the best chance for getting the right treatment quickly, avoiding any complications. And from what I hear, in terms of percentage, about 1/5 of U.S. adults get an annual physical done. And when you go for your physical exam, what are some of the things that you're going to, the doctor is going to do? Apart from using their stethoscope, checking your body, your breathing and all that, of course, you have to do the physical exams. You have to check your body mass index. That's when they put your weight and your height, and they do a, they compute by calculation. They have a, you can go online and just put in BMI calculation. It will ask you for your weight, your height. The formula will come, put it in. If your BMI is more than 28 going, then you have to watch it. I mean, after 30, you are obese and overweight. So check it. The doctor will check your BMI and make sure you are not going beyond 28. It's not healthy. They will check your skin, make sure your skin is the right color. Your skin hasn't moved from, chocolate to green or something. Because there are some diseases that when they look at you just by your eyes, it's going yellowish. They can tell you are being jaundiced. So it's very important. They check your cholesterol. They check your blood pressure. They check your eyes, your immunization records. And screening for any sexually transmitted disease. Maybe last week you were clean, but then the following year you did some, you know, hookups or some things that have actually made you acquire some disease. It's very important that, you know, you get them checked. And they check your vital signs. Like I said, height, weight, your hearing. Of course, they do your hearing. They put you under a machine where they put some earphones, you know, in your ears, and they make you listen quietly to sounds that are being produced. They are very, very, very tiny sounds, and you have to be able to pick them. If you don't, after the test, they tell you, okay, you failed. Your right ear is not hearing well. Your left ear is not hearing well. So it's very important. Check your heart rate, you know, your ears, your nose, your throat, check all that. And they screen for prostate exam for men. I mean, you have a range. I think for the lab results, your PSA should be less than 4. Yeah, the prostate, cancer thing, it has to be less than 4. If it's more than 4, then possibly you are going towards prostate cancer, which is very bad. You want to make sure all that they are screened. You can't avoid it. And then some other screens they will be doing that, they will check your hemogram or complete blood count, CBC. You have to check your white cells, your leukocyte, your platelet count. Yeah, if your platelet should be between, I think, 150 to 450 thereabout. If yours is 90 or 80, then they know it's low. If you have an injury, a cut, it's going to take a longer time for the platelets to pluck your wound. And so it's very important. They can only know that through your blood. They do your lipid profile. Lipid profile checks your cholesterol, your triglycerides, your HDL, that is a good cholesterol. Your LDL, they say, is a bad cholesterol. If your HDL is up higher, above 50s, you are very good. And your cholesterol, you know, shouldn't be more than 200. That is the norm. I mean, you can go a few over, that's fine. But then you want to be checking it. If you have cholesterol in the 300 and jack, cereal, they check your thyroid panel, your liver panel, and any other, you know, nutrients or electrolytes, your bone mineral test, you know, all that needs to be checked. So, well, I have 2 minutes. So that is what we brought to you this evening. I believe I've been able to share some information with you. It's very important that we take care of our bodies very well to have a lasting, you know, lifestyle, to be able to do all that God has promised for us. Please don't take your health for granted. It's very important. Whatever you are eating, putting into your body, you have to account for it. Whenever you put any muscle or food in your mouth, ask yourself, where is it going to end up? What is it going to do for me? How is it going to help me? I mean, for me, we went to our gala last weekend in, you know, Maryland. Of course, there were food that every once in a while you meet with your buddies, your friends, and, you know, you just put, you know, health aside and eat. I remember my friend, my classmate, Murray, he was then. Of course, Murray likes kinky. So there was kinky, and I saw Murray jumping on the kinky, the shito, pepper, and then the fish skinner. I mean, Murray was enjoying. And, you know, that's like one lifetime, I mean, once in a you know, a year thing that we all gather and we just enjoy, because sometimes you don't even have all this local food to eat in the house. So when we eat in a picnic, we meet in a picnic, like we all enjoy something for a while. But that's not supposed to be your lifestyle. Every day you have to watch what you are eating. You know, eat in moderation. Eat in moderation. Well, it's 7 o'clock, and I just want to thank you for opening your homes to Era One Health Program. We are always here. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to, you know, send a text or, you know, call in 240-280-2633, and we will be at your beck and call. So until we come your way again next week, continue enjoying Era One. We have plethora of programs every day. This is a 24/7. We have Mondays, we have the health show, we have your Yensum, you know, World Affairs. We have the Tuesday Divine Connection. Wednesday, Yensum comes back, and Thursday, we have Divine Connection. Friday, we have Count Your Blessing. Saturday, we have your health show in the evening like this. And then in the morning, we have Dr. Ostus doing his train program, where he interviews a lot of artists, people who have gifts and talents that want to adore them. If you have a gift, if you have a music career that you think nobody's promoting you, please see Dr. Ostus on 240-280-2633, and he will, you know, interview on his program, and maybe you find you some sponsors. And on Sundays, we have our the Real in Common Kitting Kitting in the evening, and you want to tune in. All right, so I will leave here in a minute and continue enjoying Era One Radio.
This is not your typical tea. The Vijo Herbal Tea by Glucose Care International is a nutritious drink and a natural blood glucose reducer. Geranium plant, the active ingredient in the Fumijo herbal tea, suppresses the absorption of carbohydrate ingested from your diet. The green tea content in the Fumijo herbal tea promotes rejuvenation of dead cells, detoxification of your system, stimulates the pancreas to release insulin, and improves metabolism. Drinking one sachet of Fumijo herbal tea after meals prevents the rise in blood sugar levels, suppresses appetite, and improves bowel movement. Drinking Fumijo herbal tea regularly after meals can also prevent type 2 diabetes. We encourage you to drink Fumijo herbal tea 3 times in a day, coupled with mild exercises to maximize its benefits. Fumijo herbal tea has been approved by the FDA. Toxicity test conducted by SGS, so it is safe and non-toxic. A product of Singapore. With Fumijo Herbal Tea, your peace of mind is guaranteed. Call our shop now on 0245-810-623 and set your path to good health.
Well, once again, I want to wish our Apsu our executive body led by Augustine Abuchi and the whole, you know, executive body, congratulations for having a good Congress gala in Maryland last week. Anyway, let me, it's time for me to wrap
Tema up. Fui, yay. TSC, together we stand. TSC Virginia is having our annual picnic on July 15th, 2023. The time is from 1 p.m. to 7 p.m. The venue is Joseph Hensley, 4200 Eisenhower Avenue, Alexandria, Virginia, 22304. Come with your family and friends, and let's have a lot of fun. Contact Harriet at 301-755-3062, Eric at 571-229-2897, Chris at 571-340-6100, and Albert at 301-399-3783.
There's still an activity going on at One Radio. There's a book launching, so don't forget to stay tuned in and enjoy. Have a good weekend, and we'll see you next week. Bye-bye.
Adruobiem.
10th edition Afro Unity Festival.
Asai Adruobiem. Sankofa African Network and Dance Music Production presents
10th edition Afro Unity Festival.
Jumadie ne basu gidi. Jumadie, esi Sankofa Radio Naso.
Basu 24th June 2023.
Ewa Lee District Park Amphitheater, 6601 Telegraph Road, Alexandria, Virginia, zip code 22310 from 12 p.m. to 7 p.m.
Jumadie ahudu opi nebekosu. Arts, food, live music, vendors, cultural exhibitions, games, and many, many more. Mamenka says surprise artist can see a bass here. For more information, visit sankoforadio.com.
And on teach media, many home film, only a busianina, na monke mumramana, and your fair message media, a bakikim, a bay bonfretter, a bay a bows again.